The respiratory tract consists of nasal cavity, oral cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, and lungs. Diaphragm is a dome-shaped muscle which serves in breathing. Now let us take a closer look at the lungs anatomy. The top rounded area of the lungs is known as apex. The bottom of the lungs is convex shaped, which rests against the concave shaped diaphragm. The mediastinum is the area present in the thorax that holds the heart and other vital structures like the great arteries, veins, and the trachea. The convex surface that faces the internal chest cavity is the costal surface. Now let us take a closer look at the lungs' medial surface. The medial surface contains hilum, which is a depressed surface that serves as an entry point and an exit point. The hilum contains opening for the bronchus, pulmonary artery, and two pulmonary veins. Now let us take a closer look at the organs associated with the lungs and their relation. The lungs are present within the thoracic cavity and are protected by the ribs. Medial to the lungs is the heart, along with the great arteries and veins present in the mediastinum. Inferior to the lungs is the diaphragm, stomach, and the liver. Anterior to the lungs are ribs. Pleura is a thin layer of tissue that covers the lungs and lines the interior wall of the chest cavity. Transverse cross-section of lungs also reveal that posterior to the lungs there is vertebral column, and anterior to the lungs there is sternum. Now let us understand the pleura with an example. Let us assume that the fist is the lung and the water-filled balloon is the pleura. If we press the balloon with the fist, two distinct outer and inner layers will be formed, which will completely cover our fist. The outer pleural membrane is known as parietal pleura, which covers the internal surface of the ribcage. The inner pleural membrane is the visceral pleura that is attached to the costal surface of the lungs. The potential space between the pleural membrane is the pleural sac that contains the pleural fluid. Now let us take a closer look at the structures present inside the lungs. The trachea is continuous with the bronchus, which divides into the smaller bronchus and bronchioles, which are then connected to the alveoli. Now let us understand the bronchus and alveoli in detail. The inhaled air passes through the trachea into the bronchus and then into the primary, secondary, and tertiary bronchus. Ultimately, the air reaches the bronchioles and alveoli, where gas exchange occurs. The important point to know is that the air conduction occurs in the bronchus, while the alveolar gas exchange occurs in the bronchioles and the alveoli. If we take a closer look at alveoli, we can see that the bronchioles are lined by smooth muscles that maintains the airway patency. The pulmonary artery carrying the oxygenated blood subdivides and make up the alveolar capillaries. After getting oxygenated, the oxygenated blood is carried back into the heart via the pulmonary vein. The alveoli also contains elastic cartilage that helps in the passive recoil during expiration. The alveolar pores also allow communication between the two adjacent alveoli. That was all about the lungs anatomy overview. If you liked the video, please like and comment, and do not forget to subscribe.